A population of a town is 1,28,000. The annual birth rate and annual death rate are 10.4% and 2.9% respectively. Then what is the town's population after 3 years? Birth rate and death rate of this town are happening simultaneously, right? So our effective percentage value would be 10.4% minus 2.9%. That would turn out to be 7.5%. Now, if you look at the number 1,28,000, you will notice that it can be written as 128,000 can be written as 2 raised to the power 7 into 1000 or 10 to the power 3, right? So by doing that, we have simplified the given figure in 2 raised to the power x sum, right? So it will help you later. Let's see how. Secondly, we know that 7.5% over a period of 3 years would act as a compound interest rate, and it would look something for a sum of, let's say, x, it would look something like 107.5 by 100 and then a cube value because it's acting for 3 years. So this calculation is going to be a little tiresome for us. So we'll try to simplify this particular number as well. We know that 2.5% can be written as 1 by 40 of a value. That gives us 7.5% to be 3 upon 40, right? And by adding it to the original value, this becomes 1 plus 3 by 40. Since we are multiplying it by, let's say, any number called x. Here, x would be this thing, 2 power 7 into 1000. So this would become 43 by 40. And since it is acting for 3 years, we'll have to be cubing it. So now, our original value, that is 2 power 7 into 10 to power 3, would be multiplying with 43 by 40 power 3, and by this simplified expression, we know that zeros in the denominator would be 3, right? Because we are cubing it over here, this 3. So this thing gets cancelled out with this. So by this, we know that our answer would not involve any zeros in it. So this eliminates option D and option A. We are left with B and C. Let's see how can we reach that. So, alright. And we also know that 4 cube can be written as 2 power 6. So 2 power 6 would cancel this. So our answer would be 2 into 43 to the power 3. So we know that our answer would be divisible by 43, and if you try to divide the given two options by 43, you would find that option C is divisible by 43, and this becomes your answer. But in case you don't want to do that either, what will you do? You will see that the increase in 1,28,000 would be more than 20%. Why 20%? Why more than 20%, in fact? Because we know that 7.5 over a period of 3 years would give us into 3 around 22.5, and it would be even more than that because it is acting for consecutive 3 years, right? And the 20% value of 1,28,000 would be somewhere around 256. And if you add these two, you'll get 153. So the answer would be something more than 153, right? So we only have one option which is more than 1,53,000, and that would give you option C. So what we have done here is we have simplified our expression values, and we have not gotten into any sort of typical cumbersome calculation, and we have saved a lot of time as well.